Good morning, friends. Hi, it's Miss Ashley. I'm so excited to see you. Today is Monday. Hello. Thanks for joining me today. I'm so happy to see you at school with me. While we wait for all of our friends to join us, let's do Shake My Sillies Out today. We've been doing Everybody Clap the past few weeks, but I thought we could bring back our other song and do Shake My Sillies Out by Raffi. Let's see if you remember how it goes.
Gotta shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Wiggle my waggles away. I gotta clap, clap, clap my crazies out. Clap, clap. Clap my crazies out, clap, clap, clap my crazies out, and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta jump,
jump,
jump, jump.
Can you stand up and jump? High to the sky.
Jump, jump, jump my jiggles out, and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies out. Yawn, 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 yawn my sleepies out. Yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies out, and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out. Shake, shake, shake my sillies out, and wiggle my waggles away. And wiggle my waggles away.
Yay! Thanks for shaking out your sillies with me this morning. That's one of my favorite songs and dances to do with you. All right, should we wake up, Barbara? I missed Barbara this weekend. I love seeing her during school. Can you help me wake her up? When I count to three, we'll say, "Hey, Barbara." Ready? One, two, three. Hey, Barbara. No Barbara yet. She's a heavy sleeper. Let's try again a little bit louder. Ready? One, two, three. Hey, Barbara! Ooh, she's starting to wake up. Let's try one more time in your biggest, loudest voice. Ready? One, two, three. Hey, Barbara! Oh, good morning, everybody. Happy Monday. I'm so happy to see you today. All right, Barbara, let's sing our hello song to our friends. Are you ready? Hello, friends. Hello, friends. How are you? How are you? We're so glad to see you. We're so glad to see you here at school. Here at school. Can you sing to me? Hello, Miss Ashley. Hello, Miss Ashley. How are you? How are you? We're so glad to see you. We're so glad to see you here at school. Here at school. Can you sing to Barbara? Hello, Barbara. Hello, Barbara. How are you? How are you? We're so glad to see you. We're so glad to see you here at school. Here at school. Wonderful singing with us, friends. You have such a lovely singing voice. Barbara and I love to hear you sing with us. All right, Barbara, this week we're learning all about bears. Do you like bears? I love bears, Miss Ashley. They are so cute. I like bears too, Barbara. We have a lot to learn today, so we will say goodbye to Barbara for now. Can you tell Barbara bye? Bye, Barbara. See you next time. Goodbye, everybody. Have a wonderful day. Bye. All right, friends. I see lots of boys and girls joining us. Hello, Graham and Maxwell. They're in Wyoming. That's where I live. And I see a friend joining us in Idaho, too. Thanks for coming to school with me today. All right, I'm going to teach you a new weather song this morning. We like to talk about the weather at school. So this song goes like this. It's called Zippy Weather. And you see this word here, how it's dark and has a line under it? That means when we get to that part of the song, you get to sing the word that describes the weather where you live. It might be rainy, sunny, snowy, windy, cloudy. You get to sing that part, and we all might say a different word. Where I live today, it's sunny, so I'll say sunshine. And this is how the song goes. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. My, oh my, what's the weather today? Plenty of, how is it? Sunshine headed our way. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. I like that weather song. It's fun to sing lots of songs at school, isn't it? All right. Starting today, we're going to do something so fun together. This is called ABC Countdown to Summer. So every day we'll talk about a letter of the alphabet and do a fun activity with that letter. So today is letter A. So we're going to talk about animals. It says, play with a pet or stuffed animal. Some of you might have a pet at your house, like a dog or a cat, maybe a fish or a hamster. Do you have a pet? I don't have any pets. I really want a dog, though. I think dogs are so fun. But I do have a stuffed animal. This is my favorite stuffed animal. My husband bought it for me a long time ago. Isn't he so cute and snuggly? Did you bring a stuffed animal with you today to watch the video with you? If you did, you can tell your grown-up to take a picture of you with your stuffed animal or with your pet, and they can share it with me, and we can all see the pictures of you with your stuffed animal or your pet. So since we're talking all about letter A, I want to introduce you to some new songs. We're going to learn about the letter A together. So these songs are by a man called Jack Hartman. He makes lots of really fun songs and videos for kids, and I use them in my school all the time. So he is going to sing us a song about the letter A, and he'll talk to us about the sounds that the letter A makes, and we get to practice writing the letter A in the air. So when he tells us to write the letter, you can use your magic finger to write the letter in the air like that, and I'll write it on my board, and we'll see if we can make the letter A together, okay? Here we go. This is Jack Hartman, letter A. And you can dance along if you want to. I like these songs.
Get ready, get set. Let's learn about the alphabet. 26 letters, that's it. Let's learn about the alphabet. Let's learn about the letter A.
Here's my letter A.
A is a letter. A is a letter. A is a letter.
A is a letter in the alphabet. This is an uppercase A. Write it in the air like this.
There's my uppercase A.
This is an uppercase A.
Can you write it in the air?
Write it in the air like this.
Good job.
This is a lowercase.
Can you write this
write
one?
It in the air like this.
Lowercase.
This is a lowercase A. Write it in the air like this.
Circle and a line. Good job.
Get ready. Get set. Let's learn about the alphabet. Letter A is a vowel.
and it has two sounds. Letter A is a vowel, and it has two sounds. I say the short sound ah, 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 ah. Now you say the short sound.
Can you say it?
Ah, ah.
Good job.
Ah, ah.
At the beginning of these words,
listen for the short sound ah.
All right, listen.
There was an alligator.
Alligator, alligator.
On an adventure.
Adventure, adventure.
To pick some apples.
Apples, apples.
To make some applesauce.
Applesauce, applesauce. Okay, was that so fun? I love learning about letters with you. So he told us some words that start with A. Can you think of some words that start with A that make the ah sound? Use your smart, smart brain to think of some words. Maybe you can tell your grown-up and they can write them in the comments so I can see. Okay, he said a few words in the video. He said apples. Let's write it down. Ah, apples. What else did he say? He said ah, alligator. Alligator starts with A too. Ooh, I know a word that starts with A. It's a name. And it's my name. Ashley starts with A. Ah, ah, Ashley. When you write a name, you use an uppercase letter. And other words use a lowercase letter. A has another sound. It says its name. A, A, A. Can you think of any words that start with A or A? What about angry? Ooh, angry is another word for mad. Can you make a mad or angry face? Good job. So these are words that start with A that make the A sound or the A sound. So today after school, you could look around your house to see if you can find any things or even people that start with A. Ooh, our friend Afton starts with A too. I'm going to write that one down. Afton and Ashley are two names that start with A. Thanks, girls. And I used an uppercase A to write her name. Oh, you are so smart. Thanks for your help thinking of lots of words that start with A. All right, so we're learning all about bears this week. I have another stuffed animal. He's a little bear. I like his tie. Bears don't wear ties, do they? But this one does. He's so cute. Okay, so I want to know, what is a bear? Do you know what a bear is? I'm going to show you some pictures, and you have to tell me, is it a bear or is it not a bear? Okay, so when I show you the picture, you can shout it out really loud so I can hear all the way in my school in Wyoming if it's a bear or not a bear. Ready? Here's the first one. Is it a bear? Yes or no? No, a tiger is not a bear. Here's the next one. Is it a bear? Yes, this one is a bear. You're so smart. Here's the next picture. Bear? Yes, again. All right, I'll trick you this time. Is this one a bear? No, that's a lion. Lions are not bears. Here's another animal. Is it a bear? No, monkeys are not bears. Here's the next picture. Bear? Yes, this one is a bear. Ooh, I like this one. Is this a bear? It is. This is a teddy bear, just like my teddy bear. Ooh, I think you'll like this one too. Is it a bear? No, it's a puppy. Oh, I like this animal. Is this a bear? No, that's a hippo. Hippos are not bears. Here's the next animal. Is this a bear? Yes, this is a polar bear. They live where it's really cold. Okay, you're so smart. Thank you for helping me. Here's the next picture. Is this a bear? No, a moose is not a bear. Ooh, this next one is so fun. Is this a bear? No, you're right again. A zebra is not a bear. Okay, we have two more. Let's see if you can get them right. Is this a bear? Yes, this is called a panda bear, and they like to eat bamboo. A panda is a bear. And here's the last one. Is this a bear? Yes, again. Oh, you're so smart. Give your brain a kiss. Good job, brain. Oh, you're so good at playing those games with me. So now we know what a bear is and what a bear is not. So I have another question. Have you ever seen a bear? Maybe your answer is, yes, I have. Or maybe your answer is, no, not yet. If you have not seen a bear, that's okay. We can see bears if you go to the zoo, or in some places there's a bear sanctuary where they take really good care of bears. You might even see bears when you go on a hike in the mountains. There's lots of different places we can see bears. So tell me really loud, have you ever seen a bear? Okay, Miss Ashley has seen lots of bears. I think they are really cool animals to watch. All right, friends, it's time for us to feed our butterflies. Remember that our caterpillars turned into butterflies, and now every day we have to feed them water mixed with sugar. That's what butterflies like to eat. Okay. Here's our butterflies. There's four in there. There's one. There's two butterfly friends right there together. And one more. I think they're really hungry. I have not fed them yet today because I wanted to wait so you could help. So remember, I use my squeezer, and you can pretend to help me too. Use your squeezer fingers like this. And here's my sugar water, and we will feed our butterflies. And maybe later this week, if the weather is warm enough, we can release our butterflies outside. All right, get your squeezer ready. Let's dip it in the water and squeeze your fingers. Squeeze. See the water inside? And we'll put the water inside so those butterflies can eat and get nice and big and strong, just like you. All right, we'll zip it closed so they don't fly away. And watch as they start to eat. Thanks for helping me feed them. All right, I would like to read you a story now. This is one of my favorite books about a brown bear. You might know this story. It's very popular. It's called Brown Bear, What Do You See? And it is written by Bill Martin Jr. And the illustrator is Eric Carle. He drew all of these pretty pictures in the book. This is Brown Bear, What Do You See? If you know this story, you can read it with me. It goes like this. Brown Bear, What Do You See? I see a red bird looking at me. Ooh, look at that big brown bear. Red bird, what do you see? I see a yellow duck looking at me. Ooh, it's a pretty red bird. Yellow duck, what do you see? I see a blue horse looking at me. Blue horse, what do you see? I see a green frog looking at me. That's a pretty blue horse, isn't it? Green frog, what do you see? I see a purple cat looking at me. Purple cat, what do you see? I see a white dog looking at me. White dog, what do you see? I see a black sheep looking at me. Black sheep, what do you see? I see a goldfish looking at me. I like the sheep's voice. Goldfish, what do you see? I see a teacher looking at me. Teacher, what do you see? I see children looking at me. Children, what do you see? Ooh, there's a lot of children on that page. Can you help me count them? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 children. What do they see? We see a brown bear, a red bird, a yellow duck, a blue horse, a green frog, a purple cat, a white dog, a black sheep, a goldfish, and a teacher looking at us. That's what we see. The end. Do you like that story? That's one of Miss Ashley's favorite books. I read this book a lot with my students when they come to school here. All right, friends, I want to show you something you can do after school today since we learned about the letter A. I will post a link for this page that you could color after school today. You could ask your grown-up to print it out for you if you have a printer. So I colored my uppercase A and my lowercase A. I practiced writing my letters and I drew a picture. It says A is for animals and apples. I drew a cow and I guess that's an apple. I'm not a very good drawer, but I tried my best. So you can do this after school if you want to. You don't have to if you don't want to. And in that link, there's also some other fun pages you could do. This one says, All About Me. You could put your favorite color, your best friends, your favorite book. You could color a picture of you if you're in preschool. This document also has ones that go up to third grade, I think. So you can write your teacher's name. If you don't have a teacher, you could write your mom or dad's name because they're being teachers right now too, aren't they? You could write your school and the school year. And when we're all done doing our ABC countdown together, you could put all of these pages together and make a book that says Alphabet Memories. That might be something fun that you could do with your family if you want to. I know lots of kids right now have a lot of extra work that they're doing, so I don't want to add too much. But if you want something fun to do, you could do that. All right, it's time for us to say goodbye. Here is our clock. Do you see the bear on the clock? Since we're learning about bears, can you point to the bear? There he is by the brown, gray, and black colors. All right, can you help me sing the goodbye song now? Goodbye now, goodbye now. The clock says we're done. We'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye, everyone. I hope you had fun with me at school today. Remember that today is letter A, all about animals. So you could play with your stuffed animal or a pet if you have a pet. And ask your grown-up to take a picture of you playing with your animal so I can see it. I would love to see pictures today. All right, I will see you tomorrow, everybody. Thanks for coming. Have a great day. Bye. See you later. Bye.